new treatment modalities in oncology under supervision of Professor Dr. Hanan Sulaiman, prepared by Amani Sabir Saad and Iman Muhammad. Outlined, introduction, treatment modalities in cancer, traditional cancer treatment modalities, surgery, radiotherapy, chemotherapy, hormone therapy. New modalities in cancer treatment, anti-angiogenesis inhibitors, thermal therapy, targeted therapy, cancer vaccines, stem cell and bone marrow transplantation, gene therapy, gold nanoparticles, complementary and alternative medicine. Our objective: at the end of this lecture, my colleague will be able to discuss different treatment modalities in cancer management. Our specific objectives: at the end of this lecture, my colleague will be able to enumerate different types of surgery, mention types of radiotherapy, provide nursing care to patients receiving chemotherapy, identify causes which make cancer cells sensitive for hyperthermia, discuss targeted therapy, list types of cancer vaccines, discuss stem cell and bone marrow transplantation in cancer treatment, mention usage of gene therapy in cancer treatment, identify gold nanoparticles, complementary and alternative medicine, and unproven and unconventional therapy in cancer management. Our introduction: cancer cells on their own aren't all that difficult to kill. Radiation or drugs can be administered to kill them off relatively easily. This problem is tumors like to hit in crowds, and whatever weapons we fire at them also tend to hit healthy cells around them. Treatment options offered to cancer patients should be based on treatment goals for each specific type of cancer. The range of possible treatment goals may include complete eradication of malignant disease, means cure, prolonged survival and containment of cancer cell growth, which means control tumor, or relief of symptoms associated with the disease, which are palliation or palliative care. Multiple modalities are commonly used in cancer treatment. A variety of approaches include surgery, radiation therapy, chemotherapy, and targeted therapy may be used at various times throughout treatment. Understanding the principles of each and how they interrelate is important in understanding the rationale and goals of treatment. First treatment option for cancer are surgery. Surgical removal of the entire cancer remains the ideal and the most frequently used treatment methods. Surgery may be diagnostic, primary, prophylactic, palliative, or reconstructive. Diagnostic surgery, which is called biopsy, is usually performed to obtain a tissue sample for analysis of cells suspected to be malignant. In most instances, the biopsy is taken from the actual tumor, but in some situations, it is necessary to biopsy lymph node near the suspicious tumor. Surgery as a primary treatment, its goal are to remove the entire tumor or as much as is feasible and any involved surrounding tissue, including regional lymph nodes, to common surgical approaches are used, which is local incisions and wide incisions. Local excision, often performed on an outpatient basis when the mass is small. It includes removal of the mass and a small margin of normal tissue that is easily accessible. Wide or radical include removal of the primary tumor, lymph nodes, adjacent involved structures, and surrounding tissues that may be at high risk for tumor spread. The surgical method can result in disfigurement and altered functioning, necessitating rehabilitation or reconstructive procedures. However, wide excisions are considered if the tumor can be removed completely and the chances of cure or control are good. This is a video assisting in endoscopic surgery. It increasingly replacing surgery associated with long incisions and extended recovery periods to minimize surgical trauma and shorten patient recovery time without compromising surgical outcomes. Prophylactic surgery. Prophylactic surgery involves removing non-vital tissues or organs that are at increased risk to develop cancer. For example, colectomy, mastectomy, and oophorectomy. The following factors are considered when physicians, nurses, patients, and family discuss possible prophylactic surgery. First, family history and genetic predisposition, presence or absence of symptoms, potential risks and benefits, ability to detect cancer at early stage, the patient's acceptance of the post-operative outcome risk to develop cancer. Palliative surgery. The goal of treatment are to make the patient as comfortable as possible and to promote quality of life as defined by the patient and his or her family. Palliative surgery is performed in an attempt to relieve complications of cancer, such as ulceration, obstruction, hemorrhage, pain, and malignant effusion. Honest and informative communication with the patients and family about the goal of surgery is essential to avoid false hope and disappointment. Reconstructive surgery may follow curative or radical surgery in an attempt to improve function or obtain a more desirable cosmetic effect. It may be performed in one operation or in stages. It may be indicated for breast, head and neck, or skin cancer. Radiation therapy. More than half of patients with cancer receive a form of radiation therapy at some point during treatment. It may be used to cure cancer or control malignant disease. In cure cancer, as in thyroid carcinomas, localized cancer of the head and neck, cancers of the uterine cervix. In control malignant disease, when a tumor cannot be removed surgically or when local nodal metastasis is present. It can be used neoadjuvantly, which means prior to a local definite treatment with or without chemotherapy to reduce the size of a tumor to enable surgical resection. Prophylactically, to prevent the spread of primary cancer to a distant area, as irradiating the brain to prevent leukemic infiltration or metastatic lung cancer. Palliative radiation therapy is used to relieve the symptoms of metastatic disease or to treat oncologic emergency, such as superior vena cava syndrome, bronchial airway obstruction, or spinal cord compression. Types of ionizing radiation. There are electromagnetic radiation as X-rays and gamma rays, particulate radiation as electrons, beta particles, protons, neutrons, and alpha particles. Its mechanism of action. Radiation leads to tissue disruption. The most harmful tissue disruption is direct alteration of the DNA molecule with the cells of the tissue. Ionizing radiation breaks the strands of the DNA, leading to cell death. Administering of radiation therapy. There are teletherapy, which means external beam radiation, brachytherapy, which means internal radiation, systemic radioisotopes, contact or surface mold. In internal beam radiation therapy, which is the most commonly used form of radiation therapy, the energy utilized generated from a linear accelerator or units that generate energy directly from a core source of radioactive material, such as gamma knife TM unit. Intensity modulated radiation therapy, which do daily fractions or hyperfractionated twice daily fractions, which shorten the duration of the patient's treatment schedule. Image-guided radiation therapy. Use continuous monitoring of the tumor with ultrasound or CT scan during the treatment. Respiratory gating. Where the treatment delivery is actually synchronized with the patient's respiratory cycle, enable the beam to be adjusted as the tumor moves. Internal radiation. Delivers a high dose of radiation to a localized area. Internal radiation can be implanted by needles, seeds, beads, or catheters into the body cavity, like vagina, abdomen, or pleura, or in an interstitial compartment as breast and prostate. Brachytherapy may be temporary or permanent, with high doses radiation or low dose radiation. Systemic brachytherapy involves the IV administration of a therapeutic radioactive isotope targeted to a specific tumor. Radioactive iodine 1131 is a widely used form of systemic brachytherapy and is the primary treatment for thyroid cancer. Radioimmunotherapy involves administration of a radionuclide chemically conjugated bound to a monoclonal antibody that specifically targets NHL tumor cells, delivering the radionuclide directly to the tumor and sparing the surrounding healthy tissue. Side effects of radiotherapy: acute local reactions that include alopecia, skin reactions that include erythema, dry desquamation, moist desquamation, and ulceration. Alteration in oral mucosa includes stomatitis, xerostomia, change and loss of taste, decreased salivation. Gastrointestinal complication as esophageal irritation, which with chest pain and dysphagia, anorexia, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. Bone marrow complications like anemia, leukopenia, and thrombocytopenia. Increased risk for infection and bleeding. Systemic side effects include fatigue, malaise, and anorexia. Last side effect, which start after delivery of radiation, 4 months, 2 years. Fibrotic change secondary to decrease the vascular supply and are irreversible. Severe late effects may affect the lung, heart, central nervous system, and bladder. Chemotherapy. Chemotherapy is anti-neoplastic agent are used to destroy tumor cells by interfering with cellular functioning, including replication. Chemotherapy is used primarily to treat systemic disease rather than localized lesions that are amenable to surgery or radiation. Chemotherapy may be combined with surgery, radiation therapy, or both to reduce tumor size preoperatively, to destroy any remaining tumor cells postoperatively, or to treat some forms of leukemia or lymphoma. The goal of chemotherapy are to cure, control, and palliation. Dosage of antineoplastic agent is based on the patient's total body surface area, previous response to chemotherapy or radiation therapy, function of major organ systems. Side effects of chemotherapy, extravasation. The consequence of extravasation range from mild discomfort to severe tissue destruction. Indications of extravasation: absence of blood from the intravenous catheter, resistance to flow of IV fluids, burning or pain, swelling, redness at the site. Hypersensitivity reaction. Type 1 hypersensitivity reactions may present as a local reaction and then rapidly progress to systemic anaphylaxis, or the initial presentation may be an acute life-threatening anaphylaxis. Gastrointestinal systems, nausea and vomiting, and anorexia, stomatitis, hematobiotic system. Most common probiotic agent cause myelosuppression or depression of bone marrow function, resulting in decreased production of white blood cells, neutropenia, anemia, thrombocytopenia, and increased risk of infection and bleeding. Alopecia or loss of hair. Nursing actions for alopecia include: discuss the impact of alopecia on self-image, discuss options such as hair turbans and wedges to deal with hair loss, inform client that hair loss occurs 7 to 10 days after treatment begin, encourage client to select hair piece before treatment start, reinforce that alopecia is temporary and hair should return when chemotherapy is discontinued. Client education include: instruct the client to avoid the use of damaging hair care measures such as electric rollers and curling iron, hair dye, and permanent waves. Use of soft hair brush or white tooth comb for grooming is preferred. Suggest that the client cut hair short before treatment to decrease weight on the hair follicle. After hair loss, the client should protect the scalp from sun exposure and use of a diaper rash ointment or cream for itching. Renal system complication. Rapid tumor cell lysis after chemotherapy result in increased urinary excretion of uric acid, which can cause renal damage. In addition, intracellular contents are released into circulation, resulting in hyperkalemia, hyperphosphatemia, and hypocalcemia. Nursing action are monitoring blood urea nitrogen, serum creatinine, creatinine clearance, and serum electrolytes level is essential. Adequate hydration decreases alkalization of the urine to prevent formation of uric acid crystals. Allopurinol may be used to prevent these side effects. Hemorrhagic cystitis is a bladder toxicity resulting from cyclophosphamide therapy. Hematuria can range from microscopic to frank bleeding, with symptoms ranging from transient irritative urination, dysuria, suprapubic pain, to life-threatening hemorrhage. Nursing action. Protection of the bladder focuses on aggressive IV hydration, frequent voiding, diuresis. Minta or Minax is a cytoprotectant agent that binds with the toxic metabolites of cyclophosphamide in the kidney to prevent hemorrhage cystitis. Cardiopulmonary system. Cumulative cardiac toxicities. Cumulative toxic effect on lung function resulting in pulmonary fibrosis. Pulmonary edema. Indirect onset of dyspnea and cough may progress rapidly to acute respiratory distress and subsequent respiratory failure. Reproductive system. Early menopause. Permanent sterility in men, temporary or permanent azoospermia, which means absence of spermatozoa. Nursing action. Banking of sperm is often recommended for men before treatment is initiated. Patients and their partners need to be informed about potential changes in reproductive function resulting from chemotherapy. They are advised to use reliable methods of birth control while receiving chemotherapy and not to assume that sterility has resulted. Fatigue, a distressing side effect for most patients that greatly affect quality of life, can last for months after treatment. Hormone therapy. Nearly 25% of tumors in men and 40% in women are known to have hormonal basis. It is used to treat cancers that use hormones to grow, such as some prostate and breast cancers. Hormone therapy is a cancer treatment that slow or stop the growth of cancer that use hormones to grow. New modalities in cancer treatment. Anti-angiogenesis inhibitors, thermal therapy, targeted therapy, cancer vaccines, stem cell and bone marrow transplantation, gene therapy, and gold nanoparticles. And anti-angiogenesis inhibitors. Nutrition to the tumor cells is provided by blood vessels, and the development of these vessels inside tumor tissues is called angiogenesis. Some chemical inhibitors known as angiogenesis inhibitors can cut off the blood supply to tumors. Thermal therapy or hyperthermia. Generation of temperature greater than physiologic fever range greater than 41.50 Celsius has been used for many years to destroy cancerous tumors. Treatment can be local, regional, whole body hyperthermia depending on the extent of area being treated. Side effect of hyperthermia treatment: skin burn and tissue damage, fatigue, hypotension, peripheral neuropathy, thrombophlebitis, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and electrolyte imbalance. Nursing action for hyperthermia. The nurse assesses the patients for adverse effects and acts to reduce the occurrence and severity of adverse effects. Local skin care at the site of implanted probes is necessary. Nursing actions for hyperthermia. The nurse assesses the patients for adverse effects and acts to reduce the occurrence and severity of adverse effects. Local skin care at the site of the implanted probe is necessary. Targeted therapies. Actions of targeted therapies include stimulation or augmentation of immune response through the use of biologic response modifiers, targeting of cancer cell growth factors, promotion of apoptosis, and genetic manipulation through gene therapy. Biologic response modifiers involve the use of naturally occurring or recombinant, reproduced through genetic engineering, agents or treatment methods that can alter the immunologic relationship between the tumor and cancer patients to provide a therapeutic benefit. Non-specific biologic response modifiers, stimulation of the immune system using non-specific agents such as BCG and Cryobacterium parvum. When injected into the patient, these agents serve as antigens that stimulate the immune system. BCG bladder instillation intravesicular is a standard form of treatment for localized bladder cancer. Monoclonal antibodies. Production of targeted antibodies for specific malignant cells to destroy the cancer cells and spare normal cells. The specificity of monoclonal antibodies is dependent on identifying K antigen proteins on the surface of tumors that are not present on normal tissue and block it, leading to apoptosis by disrupting communication between cells. Cancer vaccines. Cancer vaccines are used to mobilize the body's immune system to recognize and attack cancer cells. Cancer vaccines contain either portions of cancer cells alone or portions of cells in combination with other substances that can augment or boost immune responses. Vaccines are autologous or allogenic. Autologous vaccines are made from the patient's own cancer cells, which are obtained during diagnostic biopsy or surgery. The cancer cells are killed and prepared for injection back into the patient. Allogenic vaccines are made from cancer cells that are obtained from other people who have a specific type of cancer. These cancer cells are grown in the laboratory and eventually killed and prepared for injection. Prophylactic vaccines are given to prevent the disease. Quadrivalent human papilloma recombinant vaccine protect against human papilloma virus type 6, 11, 16, and 18 associated with common genital warts, type 2, type 6, and 11, and development of cervical cancer type 16 and 18. It is administered over a series of 3 doses to females aged 9 to 26. Therapeutic vaccine are given to kill existing cancer cells and to provide lasting immunity against further cancer development. Stem cell and bone marrow transplantation. Stem cell transplants don't usually work against cancer directly. Instead, they help to recover the ability to produce stem cells after treatment with very high doses of radiation therapy, chemotherapy, or both. They are sometimes called stem cell rescue or bone marrow rescue or intensive treatment. Gene therapy. Gene therapy includes approaches that correct genetic defect or manipulate genes to induce tumor cell destruction in the hope of preventing or combating disease. Three general approaches have been used in the development of gene therapy, which with adenovirus showing effective promise in each approach. Tumor-directed therapy, active immunotherapy, and adoptive immunotherapy. Golden nanoparticles. Golden nanoparticles exhibit unique physical and chemical properties due to their different shapes and size. Nanoparticle is essentially inert and non-toxic. The synthesis of golden nanoparticle is relatively easy, and the diameter range is relatively controllable, usually from 1 to 150 nanometer. Golden nanoparticles can be good drug carriers because different features and sizes can control the release of drugs in different locations. Golden nanoparticle used as a drug delivery agent targeting cancer cells and applied in tumor imaging and in tumor radio sensitizing in applied in tumor hyperthermia, complementary and alternative medicine, act as a diverse medical and healthcare systems practice, and products that are not presently considered to be a part of conventional treatment. Complementary medicine denotes therapy in conjunction with conventional medicine, whereas alternative medicine denotes therapy used instead of conventional medicine. Complementary and alternative medicine are mind-body and biofield therapy have a holistic focus on challenging positive energy, channeling positive energy, promoting relaxation and reducing stress, and have been reported as being beneficial to patients as measured by wound healing and the reduction in pain, edema, and anxiety. Patients often receive vitamins and dietary supplements as harmless natural products that have no side effect or potential toxicities.